First of all, what is team cohesion? According to Karen 1982, the definition of team cohesion is the dynamic process which reflected in the tendency for a group to stick together and remain united to achieve goals and objectives.
There are two types in this team cohesion. The first is task cohesion. The task cohesion is when a team set a goal and they work together to achieve the goal or to achieve the objective. The second is social cohesion. Social cohesion means how well the team communicate. It is referred to the members of a team interact each other. When a team win a game, they have a good task cohesion. And if the players support each other, they have a high level of social cohesion.
Hey, so why team cohesion are very important in sport?
Hey bro, who are you? This is my video.
Sorry.
Get out. So, why team cohesion is important in sport? First, it will improve performance of the team. Second, it will improve motivation of the team. Third, it will improve personal satisfaction. And then, it will increase the commitment of the team. And last but not least, it will help the team get a strong bonding and work together in harmony and achieve goal as a champion.
There are four factors in this team cohesion. First factor is environment factor. Environment means a group of people live around the players, such as family members. Second is personal factor. Personal is every team members in a team have a similar character and attitude, and they eager to achieve the goal or the objective of the team. Third is leadership factor. Leadership refers to the coach or the manager. They have a big influence to the team members and the team cohesion. And the last factor is team factor. Team factor means the team have a clear goal and clear objective to achieve, and they have a great communication among the team members.
So for the next part, we will explain how to build team cohesion.
First part, we will look at the role of the coach and the manager.
First role of the coach, they need to set the team goals.
Second role of the coach, they need to set the individual goals.
And then, they need to provide feedback for individuals as well as a team.
And the last role of the coach, they need to listen to the feedback or opinion from the players.
So next, we look at the role of the team. First, coach and players need to social together and respect each other.
Second, the team need to work together to achieve the goal.
And then, the team needs to keep communicate to work effectively.
And the last one, the team need to create dependency on each other so that no player feel or act in isolation.
And finally, we will show you guys a few activity that you guys can do in order to be team cohesion. Lash me, hitting that boy the five. Lastly, there are few conclusions in this team cohesion.
First, team cohesion is formed from the effort of each team members.
Second, each team members need to respect each other.
Third, team strength increase when the team cohesion exists.
And last but not least, the higher team cohesion will give success to the team.
The answer is personal. The answer is
2.
The answer is leadership. The answer is team members make their own decisions.